In this tutorial, we'll do a practical example about logical expressions and Boolean functions. So let's say we have the following scenario. In a manufacturing plant, 10 items are tested. So for each item, two quantities are evaluated, the p-value and the q-value. So the p-value must be greater than a minimum value of 1.3, and the q-value must not exceed a maximum value of 0.5. So we want to calculate the percentage of items that have passed the p-test alone, the q-test alone, and the two tests together. So let's first select cell C2 and give it a meaningful name. So go to the name box here and click inside of it and type in p-minimum and hit the enter key. So if you deselect anywhere, and you go to the name box and click on this down arrow and choose p minimum, this will automatically select cell C2. So in this way, when you type in the formula, it will be more relevant to the reader. Now let's do the same for cell C3 and type in the name Qmax and hit the enter key. Now go to cell C6. So now we want to input a logical expression that says if p is greater than p minimum, return a true value, otherwise return a false value. So equal, select cell A6, greater than, and just type in p min, which is the name of cell C2, and hit Ctrl Enter. So this will return a true value. Now, let's say instead of returning a Boolean value, we want to return the number 1. So you remember that 1 is equivalent to a true value and 0 is equivalent to a false value. So we want to return a number instead of a Boolean value. So to do this, double click on this cell and just enter double negation signs and close the logical expression with two parentheses and hit Ctrl Enter. So this will return a 1 value instead of true and 0 value instead of false. Now use the autofill handle and drag to the last cell, which is C15. Let's do the same for the Q test. So equal, double negation signs, then open up the parentheses, select cell Q6. Now it must not exceed the Qmax, then less than, type in Qmax. Now you can type in the name of cell C3, which is Qmax, and let's say you forgot the name of cell C3. You can just hit the F3 key on the keyboard and it will show all the names for all the cells that you put. So double click on Qmax and this will automatically insert the name of cell C3, which is Qmax. Close the parentheses and hit Ctrl Enter and use the autofill handle to drag to cell D15. Now for the two tests, this should return a 1 value if the P test is 1 and the Q test is also 1. So if one of them is 0, it should return a 0 value, meaning that the item passed the two tests together. So equal, double negation sign, we'll use the AND Boolean function. So if this cell is equal to 1, this is the first logical expression, insert a comma. Now if cell D6 is also equal to 1, close the parenthesis and hit Ctrl Enter and drag to autofill. Now if you want to calculate the percentage of items passing each test, so this is the summation of these tests, so the summation of all the ones divided by the total number of tests, which is 1. So this is mainly equivalent to the average. So the average is summation over the count. So we can say equal average and select all these cells and hit Ctrl Enter, and we can drag to autofill. Now, if you want to convert these numbers to percentages, go to the number section in the home tab and click on this percent sign, and it will convert all the number to percentages.